Kathy Ritvo's heart was racing during the Kentucky Derby. Well, not her heart, but the one that she received in a transplant 2 years ago. Ritvo made it to her first run for the Roses as the trainer of Mucho Macho Man. But it was she, not the horse, that was the long shot in this race.
It would take forever to get over my colds, and anytime I got sick, it seemed like, you know, I had to go to the doctors. It just seemed like my system was always weak.
Diagnosed with cardiomyopathy, inflammation of the heart muscle, back in 2001, Ritvo had to stop training horses for nearly 6 years as her condition deteriorated.
Tiredness, I was sick to my stomach, everything hurt, my feet hurt, my head hurt. I was miserable. I was miserable to be around. I was limited on my my fluid intake, so I could drink like 2 8-ounce cups of water all day with lots and lots of pills.
And there was no rest in sleep.
I would sleep mostly like with my knees on the floor, leaning over the bed, just because I didn't. It was too uncomfortable to lay flat because I would cough too much, because my heart was not good at all.
She watched the 2008 Kentucky Derby from her hospital bed, waiting for a heart transplant. It took nearly 7 months, one more of which her doctors didn't think she would survive.
It was such a poor quality of life that I was living, and I wanted to stop, you know, what I was doing to my family, and either, you know, have a chance of living a good life or, you know, just stopping.
There was positively times that I thought that she wasn't going to make it. She was very sick. Barely could sleep at night, coughing all the time, legs blown up like tree stumps. I mean, there was some bad, bad times.
Ritvo left the hospital 7 days after her transplant and returned to work 6 months later. She says while she is extra careful around the dirty barn and unpredictable horses, her only real alteration is taking some 30 pills a day.
I am surprised. I'm surprised that I can do everything. You know, I really have a normal life.
A life she hopes others with her condition can see is just bursting out of the starting gate.
This means that if anybody's sick or anybody's unhealthy or anybody's on a list waiting, in 2 years how your life can change so dramatically. If it gives some people ideas that their organs are valuable and they can save other people's lives so that they can go on and complete their dreams, this is kind of what we hope happens.
I hope that they see it and say that not only did I get a heart transplant, but I held on. I mean, I held on, and they can hold on, too. I hope that they see that their quality of life could be great.
Dr. Sanjay Gupta, CNN, reporting.